I'm back and I'm still cool.
Welcome to the inside of my closet,
where today we'll be discussing Sabrina Carpenter.
For the last 2 weeks, I have been walking around my house going,
I'm working late because I'm a singer. Ooh, that's that her espresso and it's good and I'm sipping it daily. So I couldn't help myself. Let's get into it, shall we? Sabrina Carpenter is a child actress turned pop superstar who made her acting debut in 2011 on a little TV show known as Law & Order SVU.
I remember it bad, but I can't say anything else.
You know, Paula, anything you can tell me could stop this man from hurting another little girl. I just want you to know you can talk to me.
That was my mother's favorite TV show. She also had a recurring role in a sitcom called The Goodwin Games in 2013. But what made Sabrina Carpenter become Sabrina Carpenter was her Disney Channel debut in 2014 with a lead role on the show Girl Meets World.
I've been waiting for a day like this to come, struck like lightning. My heart's beating like a drum on the edge of something wonderful.
She also starred in the movie The Adventures in Babysitting in 2016.
Lola grabbed our real babysitter Jenny's phone by mistake.
Way to go, Klutz.
And answered.
I'm desperate for a babysitter. I'll pay double.
Of course.
This is not happening.
Okay, so in a few short years, we've established ourselves as like a little teen starlet. We're on the Disney Channel. We're making probably a lot of fucking money, by the way. Disney doesn't play with those Coogan accounts. Alongside her Disney Channel debut, Miss Sabrina Carpenter also began releasing music in 2014, with her first release being an EP called Can't Blame a Girl for Trying. It's a very homegrown teeny bop sound. I mean, she was like a young teenager when she recorded it and released it. And it peaked at number 16 on the Billboard Heat Seekers chart. Sabrina has had a tumultuous relationship with the Billboard charts. We will get into it, but this is where it begins. So not the Billboard Hot 100, not the Billboard Hot 200, Billboard Heat Seekers were at 16. I think at the age of 16 too. Don't fucking quote me on this. And then on April 14th, 2015, Sabrina released her debut album, Eyes Wide Open. This debuted at number 43 on the Billboard 200. Very different than the Hot 100. This is the Billboard 200. I don't know. But what I do know is that Eyes Wide Open sold 12,000 copies in its first week. Not bad. Can't blame a girl for trying. For a debut album from a Disney Channel star, it was received by critics pretty well. Brian Cantor from Headline Planet wrote, "Those who can convey that meaning, that unique sense of whom they are and what they want to say, are the ones that deserve admiration. They are the ones who deserve to be called wise beyond their years. They are the ones who deserve to be labeled artists." Sabrina Carpenter's endearing, memorable debut, Eyes Wide Open, proves she is deserving of those labels. This was 10 years ago. This was in 2014, the very, very beginning of her music career. And I think he nailed it when he said, they are the ones who deserve to be labeled artists. So now we're in 2016. We've marketed our debut album, we've sold it, we've kind of squeezed all the juice we can out of it, and we're moving on. And I've talked on this channel extensively about the sophomore slump when it comes to the releasing of music, and that's where we're at. We're at the sophomore album. In 2016, Sabrina releases her second album called Evolution. This is the first time Sabrina moved away from like that Disney Channel sound, very teeny bop, like, hey guys, it's me and I love wearing my tankinis. And this record had a really heavy dance pop sound. Evolution debuted at number 28 on the Billboard Hot 200. And in the first week, it sold 11,500 copies. So a pretty comparable debut week. This album, however, did produce her first top 40 radio hit called Thumbs.
Somewhere in the world there is a father and a mother, and the father is a son who has a mother.
This doesn't sound anything like what Sabrina Carpenter sounds like today, and as someone who has just very recently begun to get into Sabrina Carpenter, whoa. This album was also received relatively well by critics. Brittany Goldfield Rodriguez of And Pop gave the album 3.8 stars, saying, quote, "With Evolution, Sabrina is showing a mature musical side, willing to experiment with techno beats, lyrics, and what she can do vocally. She provides an interesting indie yet synth take on pop music and has clearly found a unique sound that she shines in that separates her from the rest." And that goes back to the debut album where she's being for the first time labeled as an artist. Now we can see in the reviews of her music, she's starting to figure out her sound. So again, Really nice job. Sabrina's career has very consistently done this. Slow, 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 slow climb. There hasn't ever been a moment where she just dropped suddenly. It was really cool going back doing my research for this because there is a very clear paper trail of exactly how Sabrina Carpenter got to where the fuck she is today.
Sabrina Carpenter is about to blow the fuck up.
So I'm not entirely sure like what her contract situation was at this point, but now we're on her third and fourth studio albums and she did these as like a pair release. So for albums three and four, we get albums called Singular Act 1 and Singular Act 2. Both dance pop records. They both did fine. Singular Act 1 debuted at 103 on Billboard Hot 200. Singular Act 2 debuted at 138 on the Billboard Hot 200. This really stood out to me. This is one of the reviews that Singular Act 1 got. This is from Mike Need of Idolater. He referred to the album as, quote, lush with potential hits and another, quote, near perfect work from one of the industry's brightest young stars. That sounds complimentary. But it's not. Lush with potential hits. Another near perfect work. Singular Act 1 was released on November 9th, 2018. Singular Act 2 was released on July 19th, 2019. So there's a little over 6 months in between these two records. And it's clear she went to the shed for a little bit for the second act because it was rated really, really highly. It was rated much, much better. It was received much, much better by critics than the first one was. Affinity rated this album 5 out of 5 stars. AllMusic rated this album 4.5 out of 5 stars. It didn't make any waves on the charts. It didn't produce any radio hits. It didn't produce any sort of viral content online. Streaming was in its infancy still at that time, but it didn't produce any real big streaming success either, which was possible. I don't know. This is what I mean by she's really battling with this Billboard thing. So far, we don't have any number one hits, and we've been releasing music for 6-7 years at this point. Her only number ones so far have been on dance charts.
I think at this point, Sabrina knew something needed to change. So in January 2021, she signed with Universal Music Group. They have a budget,
and you're not gonna believe it. Her first release under UMG is a song called Skin.
Maybe we could have been friends if I met you in another life.
First entry of the Billboard Hot 100. It debuts at number 48. So at this point, I'm sure she's feeling much better about her situation, okay? She's released her new single. She's kind of tested the water a little bit about like what the vibe is with this new contract. And on July 15th, 2022, she releases her fifth studio album, Emails I Can't Send. First week, 18,000 units, girl. Catch it. Now we're raking in some cash. This album produced 5 singles. Skinny Dipping, Fast Times, Nonsense, Vicious, and Feather. The album debuted at number 23 on the Billboard 200. Let's get into some of these reviews, okay? Savannah Roberts at Capitol says, the songstress, quote, showed her impressive range on the record, including everything from ballads to insanely catchy empowerment anthems. Whoa, bit of a different tone there. A really clear, this is great work, job well done, nothing left to be wanted. Liam Hess of Vogue says the album is, quote, the most fully realized vision of Carpenter the musician and the most rounded portrait of Carpenter the human being yet. Girl, by the end of 2022, Billboard ranked this album number 19 out of 50 of the best albums of 2022. And not just Billboard, Rolling Stone ranked this number 44 out of 100 of the best albums released in 2022. Isn't it crazy what the right team can do for you? We're doing well, cause we're with UMG. So we're on our fifth album. Again, we've very consistently done this and we are reaching what looks like a peak. This is the most famous, the most celebrated, the most accepted and listened to that Sabrina Carpenter has ever been. And what starts at the beginning of 2023?
Have you heard of the Eras Tour?
Welcome to the Eras Tour!
And I don't want to spoil it for you, but Sabrina Carpenter is an opening act on that tour. This is where Cody comes into the picture, because this is where I started to realize Sabrina Carpenter is like, really, really fucking good at what she's doing. I will be very candid with you. I'm not afraid to admit and also publicly apologize to one of my best friends, Sage. When Emails I Can't Send first came out, in the first week, my friend Sage texted me and said, you should listen to this album. It's very good. She's going to be huge. And I said, yeah, okay, Sage. And I listened to it and I didn't like it. I thought she was sort of like a rebranded version of Ariana Grande. Then the Eras Tour rolls around and I saw her on stage performing the music that she had written. And I was like, holy fucking shit, this girl is crazy talented. She was doing something at the Eras Tour that really reminded me of the 1989 World Tour. One of the singles off the album called Nonsense, there's an outro to it. And on the record, it's very silly, it's very tongue-in-cheek. And on her own tour, when she was touring the album Emails I Can't Send, she, every time she went to a new city, would choose a new outro. And it was always very explicit, it was always very, you know, sultry and sexy. And on the Eras Tour, that took the fuck off. And it reminds me of when Taylor would do the city chant in Blank Space. Because people started to go to these shows to see Sabrina Carpenter open, to see what she was gonna do as an outro. Marketing, genius moves, and that's all her. You're on the biggest stage in the world and you're going viral. You're beating out the tour that you're opening for. That's what people dream of. That's, you can't buy that. You cannot buy that. In each city she went to with Taylor Swift and the Eras Tour, these outros became more and more popular, got more and more views that translate directly to streams, for her at least. Perfect storm. So where are we at today? We're currently in our espresso era with Miss Sabrina Carpenter. This has been her fastest selling single, not even single, this has been her fastest selling release to date. This was her first top 10 on the Billboard Hot 100. She also just performed Espresso on SNL.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sabrina Carpenter.
And you're not gonna believe it, she did a little combination of some of the singles from Emails I Can't Send, including Nonsense with an outro specifically for SNL.
Once again, Sabrina Carpenter.
Kids 30 rock hard cause I said hi. My sense of humor is, but I am not dry. SNL, I just came for the first time.
In my Chapel Roan video, I talked about creating an experience that people will expect to see from you and having that experience be so perfectly curated to be a Chapel Roan experience, a Taylor Swift experience, a Sabrina Carpenter experience. And that's where she's at in her career. She is fine lining and detailing what it means to see Sabrina Carpenter live and who Sabrina Carpenter is with that label. Artist. So where do I think Sabrina Carpenter's going? The fucking moon. She's gonna be a pop superstar. I wouldn't have said this probably 4 or 5 months ago. Espresso totally changed my mind about where she's going. And I don't know if she would agree with me, but I think that slow burn absolutely became an inferno with Espresso. And now I absolutely would include her in this new crop of like pop superstars, Chapel Roan, Renee Rapp, Sabrina Carpenter. But there's a big challenge that's gonna come with that, because how did she get here in part? Taylor Swift. When the Eras Tour is all done and Sabrina Carpenter is no longer promoting her records on top of promoting Taylor Swift, do we think she'll be able to escape the Swift sphere? Do we think she'll be able to escape the, oh, she opened for Taylor Swift. Oh, she's friends with Taylor Swift. Oh, she and Taylor Swift, or oh, Taylor Swift and Sabrina Carpenter. Will people be able to keep Taylor Swift's name away from Sabrina Carpenter long enough for Sabrina Carpenter to cement herself as an individual pop star, not just a supporting act? I think so. I think absolutely. And that's because of exactly where she's at and what she's doing with that fine liner, saying this is what Sabrina Carpenter is, these are the colors of Sabrina Carpenter, this is what you can expect. This is where I think she is right now in her career. She's cementing herself as Sabrina Carpenter, the artist. Because going back to what Brian Cantor said from Headline Planet, she is one of the ones who deserves to be called wise beyond her years. She is one of the ones who deserves to be labeled as an artist. Let me know down below, are you a Sabrina Carpenter fan? The answer is probably gonna be yes, so I'm just gonna skip that and also ask you, what's your favorite Sabrina Carpenter song? I'm not even gonna pretend like mine is an espresso. Also, as a total side note, she has done wonders for the pronunciation of espresso in the general public. Thank God to her and her espresso. If you are a fan of Sabrina Carpenter, will you recommend some of your favorite Sabrina Carpenter songs down below? I do not like her dance pop stuff. I'm gonna be very honest with you. I tried it. I don't like it. Send it back to the kitchen, please. I'm working late. Because I'm a TikToker. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if I made you smile, if I made you laugh, if you would like to help me move out of this godforsaken fucking house, buy me a coffee. The link is in the description. And if you simply cannot hold yourself over until Monday, my sweet, sweet child, and you need just another fix of my comedic genius, my comedic stylings, literally anywhere else, everywhere else, I'm Cody Jacob.